deal with the wind with the Fooler. Right now I got this set up for a real light bite. You can see where it's coming up off the base. So if you get a windy day and that wind's starting to whip this flag, you can see what can happen at that light bite. So obviously you're going to have to put a little more tension on it. So you just move your O-ring forward a bit. Now I'll just put a little more tension on it. Now that flag can whip around. It's not going to be going off. Now if you're fishing a heavier bait and you got this set all the way forward, you put the flag up against the stop. Now if you see the wind's blowing, you can see where this is starting to move back. And if you got a bigger minnow on there, if he takes a little run, he could trip this up. So we found a solution for that. If you notice, we put a second hole in the flag about a half inch up from the bottom one. So all you have to do is slide that clip out, move it to that second hole, and this will solve your problem. So now if we set this up again and put it up against the stop again, now you can see if that wind is shaking that flag back and forth, it's staying up against the stop. So I recommend doing that if you get a real windy day, 15, 20 mile an hour wind or more, and that'll solve your problem. I'd also do that if you're using heavier bait as well for northern, say you're using some big shiners. One other thing I want to mention on a windy day, you might get snow accumulating on top of the base. Right here's your solution. We found ice cream pails work real good. I notched this one out. You can scoop a bunch of slush in there, get it weighed down good, and that'll elevate it up off the snow. That'll solve that problem as well. So just a couple more helpful hints out there to deal with the wind. Guys, stay tuned for future videos. We'll be giving you some more updates.